Good evening. Please remain standing and join Riley Woodward for our invocation.
Please bow your heads. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for this special day and for all of my classmates who have made it this far. Thank you for giving us the talents, abilities, and self-discipline required for this wonderful accomplishment. We are grateful to you for providing the mentors, teachers, coaches, and counselors who have taught us, nurtured us, and challenged us along the way. As we gather here today to celebrate a step toward new places with new people and new experiences, let us not forget the blessings that follow behind us. For this school, which has given us a safe place to learn and a strong foundation to build upon as we take this next step into your world. For our teachers, who have so richly loved and cared for us. For our families, who have cheered us on to the finish line and stood by our side throughout the many bumps in the road. And on this day especially, we thank you for the friends that we have found among our classmates. For all the jokes that we will laugh about in years to come. For the hardships and tears we have endured together side by side. And for your love, which has been made evident through the relationships we will carry beyond these walls. I pray for wisdom and guidance for all our future endeavors, and I pray that we will give all glory to you as this next step in our chapter of our lives begins. And in your name I pray, amen.
For over 200 years, the men and women of our armed forces have defended the United States and have continued to keep vigilant watch over our great nation. We are honored to have among our guests tonight men and women who have served or are currently serving in our armed services. If anyone in our audience tonight has served in the U.S. Armed Forces, would you please rise so that we can honor you? Two of our graduating seniors have also committed to serving our country through military service. Seniors, step forward as I call your name. Dalton Anders, U.S. Army. Jackson Daigle, U.S. Army. Thank you.
Please stand and join me in our national pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Now for the pledge to the Texas flag. Honor the Texas flag. I pledge allegiance to thee, Texas, one state under God, and one indivisible. Please remain standing for the playing of the national anthem.
I would now like to introduce the 2023 Mineola Independent School District Board of Trustees. Mr. Ronnie Watkins, President. Ms. Jill Quambo, Vice President. Ms. Janice Etheridge, Secretary. Mr. Glenn Dossett, Mr. Robbie Baylard, Mr. Todd Morgan, and Mr. Jay McGow. In addition to our board members, I am pleased to introduce Mr. Cody Mize, the MSD Superintendent of Schools, Mr. David Sauer, Assistant of Superintendent, Mr. William Bjork, Assistant Superintendent, and our high school principal, Mr. Mike Sorensen.
You've probably noticed an empty chair on our stage. It sits in honor of Dr. John Abbott. Dr. Abbott served this district as a teacher, curriculum director, superintendent, and board member. He also served in the Alba Golden and Grand Saline school districts as a counselor, and most recently as a classroom teacher preparing the next generation of teachers. Those who know Dr. Abbott knew his impact reached way beyond his 49 years of service. His commitment to our students was second to none. Dr. Abbott was the definition of integrity, and his love for Mineola and Mineola ISD was unmatched. He was a friend and mentor to all of us and will never be forgotten.
You may have noticed our principal, Mr. Sorensen, carrying what looked like a large piece of wood. The ceremonial mace has been a symbol of scholarship and integrity since the 11th century, and it is used to lead the academic procession at commencement and other special ceremonial occasions, signifying the importance of the event and the confirmation of the academic process. Harold and Sissy Phillips donated the East Texas pecan wood in honor of Governor James Stephen Hogg and the first national-born governor of Texas and former resident of Mineola. It was crafted by their son, John Phillips, class of 1984, and presented to the principal by the junior historians in 2016. Printed or carved on the four sides of the ceremonial mace are our school motto, Pride Through Excellence, the year 1881, which is the year that the Mineola Independent School District was first incorporated. A quote from Marabou B. Lamar, dated December 20th, 1838, that says, "It is admitted by all that the cultivated mind and the guardian genius of democracy, and while guided and controlled by virtue, is the noblest attribute of man." And the fourth side simply has the block letter M.
Welcome, parents, guardians, grandparents, brothers and sisters, family and friends of the 128 amazing young men and women sitting in front of me tonight. It's been a long time coming. It's an honor and a privilege to stand here tonight today and celebrate with you this long-awaited accomplishment of the class of 2023. I've had the privilege of serving as their middle school principal, the dean of Mineola High School, and now full circle, back to being their principal once more at MHS. And guys, it's been a fun ride. Thank you for being here tonight to share in this momentous occasion. We are side by side outside tonight, and we are family again. We're here to celebrate. So this is your time. Let these graduates know that you're here. Let's make some noise. I want to take just a moment to recognize some other distinguished guests we have here tonight, our high school counselors, Ms. Rachel Wernicke and Ms. Tashara Stevens. My high school assistant principal, Ms. Melissa Foster, and she's with her son graduating at Grand Saline tonight. Our middle school principal, Ms. Kendall Gould. Our middle school assistant principal, Mr. Joshua Schnook. Our elementary principal, Ms. Brittany Thompson. Our elementary assistant principal, Ms. Angela Shine. Our primary school principal, Ms. Jolie Ray. Our primary assistant principal, Mr. James Nabenshue. And I would like to give a special recognition to Ms. Catherine Elmore, one of our senior sponsors, who has gone the extra mile this year to organize events and to take these kids and have a great time with them. In the back, we have Mr. Jason Goodson and Miss Cynthia Clark, who are in charge of the sound system tonight and be the voice of the Jackets introducing these graduating seniors. And lastly, Miss Patty Hawkins, who organizes graduation and many other events throughout the year as she has year after year after year. We love you, Miss Patty. I would like to take a minute to recognize all the teachers and staff of Mineola High School. Would you stand if you work at Mineola High School? These are my heroes right here, every day investing in our kids and in the future of tomorrow. We love you guys. You may sit down. Tonight we are also privileged to have teachers, custodians, food service workers, bus drivers, classroom aides, substitute secretaries, central office workers. If you work for Mineola ISD, would you please stand in any fashion at all? All of these employees present tonight have played a major role in the lives of our seniors, and tonight we give thanks to you, Mineola family, for the impact that you've had on these young men and women. Seniors, you have spent the last 13 years of your life working toward this momentous occasion. In the stands behind you are hundreds of people who have loved, encouraged, and supported you along the way. Sitting beside you are years of friendships and memories that will last a lifetime. Together, these experiences that you've shared will become the stories that you tell for decades to come. You'll look back one day and realize these were the good times. I am forever thankful for every teacher that you've had along the way, for your pastors and Sunday school teachers, your little league ball coaches, your dance recital coaches, for every neighbor, employer, every community member who saw value in you and who took the time to mentor and invest in you. You see, they have been painting brushstrokes on the canvas of your life. You carry a small part of each and every one of them with you. They've become a part of who you are, and I'm proud to stand here and say, I'm looking forward to seeing you and what you'll accomplish in the next season of your life. I feel confident saying that the foundation is in place for you to chase your dreams, and I'm not worried at all about your academic foundation. You've been taught by the best teachers, trained by the best coaches and directors. You can go to any school and compete with confidence. So I began to think to myself, what could I tell you that might help you as you start this new adventure in life on the right foot, the journey that begins after graduation? And this is what my heart said you should know. You won't ever sit in a high school classroom as a student again, but you'll carry what you learned there with you forever. Life is all about balance, so keep the scale steady as you move into the future. Love and be loved. Have friends and show friendship. Speak the truth and stay true to yourself. Don't ever think you have to compare yourself to others. Your journey is uniquely yours, no matter where you go or how you travel it. Patience and politeness are virtues often overlooked in today's world. Use both, and you'll be surprised at how far they'll take you. I know you'll accomplish great things, but I've got a little advice. Never doubt yourself, and surround yourself with people who will support your dreams. I'm going to say that again. Surround yourself with people who will support your dreams. One benefit of growing up in a small town and a small school like Mineola is having the opportunity to experience and learn from the core values of that community. Mineola is one of those rare, special communities where this is still true. I would like to quickly encourage you with my thoughts on three of our core values: resilience, empathy, and integrity. Seniors, you're about to leave all that you've become comfortable with, that you felt safe with. with all the things that provided consistency in your life. You're going to hear the word no more than you would like. You will experience disappointment and face obstacles that you've never had to face before. The real world is not always kind and forgiving like our small town world is. That's when you need to practice resilience to face those challenges. Resilience gives you the capacity to rebound, to recover quickly from difficulties. You're going to learn to pick yourself up, dust yourself off, and try again. So stand tall and show the world what you're made of. When the world beats you down, find a reason to get back up. Never, ever give up on yourself. Instead, I challenge you to boldly go in the direction of your dreams. And when you look back on life, you won't have any regrets. You see, when we tackle obstacles, we find hidden reserves of courage and resilience we didn't know we had. And it's only when we're faced with failure that we realize that these resources were always there within us. Seniors, the road ahead of you won't always be easy, but I've seen you work through challenges and come out stronger than ever. I want you to know that I believe in you. The current state of affairs in this world seems to focus on our differences and to highlight those differences in order to divide or separate us. I believe we got a lot of work to do in that area. And one way to address this dilemma would be to replace anger and dissension with empathy. Seniors, your generation has often been much better at trying to deeply understand what someone else is feeling and what it's like to be in their situation than mine. And I commend you for that. Alfred Adler once said that empathy is seeing with the eyes of another, listening with the ears of another, and feeling with the heart of another. My generation grew up saying you need to walk a mile in another man's shoes to know his situation. I want to publicly stand here and thank you, seniors, for demonstrating to us all how to live and work and solve problems in harmony, and to encourage you to continue to be the light for those that follow you. If I could only teach one value to live by, it would be this. Success will come and go, but integrity is forever. Integrity means doing the right thing all the time and in all circumstances, whether or not anyone is watching. It takes courage to do the right thing, no matter what the consequences will be. Just remember, profit in dollars and power is temporary, but the profit in a network of people who trust you as a person of integrity is priceless. Dennis Waitley once said, "A life lived with integrity, even if it lacks the trappings of fame and fortune, is a shining star whose light others may follow in the years to come." I encourage you to be the light. And lastly, my wife for years has spoken and prayed scripture over our boys, and I know that it has made all the difference. I would like to take a moment to speak over you tonight from Ephesians 1:15-19. "I too do not cease giving thanks for you while making mention of you in my prayers, that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give you a spirit of wisdom and of revelation in the knowledge of him. I pray that the eyes of your heart may be enlightened so that you will know what the hope of his calling is, what are the riches of the glory of his inheritance in the saints, and what is the surpassing greatness of his power toward us who believe." It has been an honor to have a front row seat to this first chapter of what's going to be your incredible life. God bless you. I love you, seniors. At this time, I would like to welcome our salutatorian for the class of 2023, Miss Campbell Littlefield.
Good evening, fellow graduates, esteemed faculty, parents, and guests. I am deeply honored to stand before you today as the salutatorian of the 2023 graduating class of Mineola High School. I would like to say thank you to all of my family here today. Without the endless support from each and every one of you, I would not be in the position that I am at. I would also like to thank the other guests and families in attendance tonight for being here to support this milestone in our lives. Lastly, I would like to give a huge thank you to everyone in the class of 2023. I know that I may have only gone to Mineola High School for the past 2.5 years, but all of you have made this short amount of time very memorable. I have been given a multitude of opportunities and possibilities during my time at Mineola, and I am very grateful for that. Over the past 13 years of my education, I have gone to 9 different schools on 3 different continents, but none of them have compared to MHS or the town of Mineola. This school has been a very welcoming environment and has provided a great sense of community. Since my first day here, I have been surrounded by warm smiles and open arms from people who were only strangers to me. Those strangers quickly became friends, and I am blessed to have made so many lifelong friendships and some true friends that will be here till the end. That being said, the graduation of this class is a very bittersweet moment. We always knew this day would come. We'd be sitting one by one with our future in our hands, each of us with so many dreams and so many plans, though I think that some of us can agree that it came rather quickly and others not fast enough. All of our lives, all that we have known is going to school for 8 hours, seeing the same faces in the halls, and going through the same routine that would only slightly differ from year to year. However, instead of continuing to fall into this routine, we will now all go our separate ways and begin our own lives. We will no longer have the comfort or familiarity and consistency. Instead, we will be faced with new days filled with opportunities as we seek to find our place in this world. The sweeter part, however, is that it is very fulfilling to know that all the work that we have put in is finally paying off, and we can all get that sense of accomplishment. Since our first day of school in 2010, we have been waiting for the year 2023. And with each passing day, the anticipation grew. As the assignments got harder and the days grew longer, we looked forward to today more and more. To say the least, we have put in so much work and effort day after day, and to walk this stage is not only a big sigh of relief, but also a wonderful achievement. As every one of us worked on accomplishing our goals in life, it is important to not forget everyone and everything that helped us along the way. Whether it was a teacher who pushed you to work your hardest, a coach who worked you to your fullest potential, or a couple of Quizlets that got you a passing grade, we all have a reason to be grateful for the help graciously given to us. There's always going to be another mountain, and you're always going to want to make it move, so you must continue to have a support system to allow you to do so. In the next couple years of our lives, many things may be uncertain, and with uncertainty comes hopelessness, fear, and disparity. At times, you may get the impression that every move you make feels lost with no direction. Though for some this may not be an issue, for the majority it will be, and the best way to get through this would be to make sure you have someone or something to fall back on when faced with obstacles. Although this statement holds true, we have proven that we are able to overcome challenges and prosper simultaneously. Since the beginning of our high school careers, we have been unknowingly building up so many attributes that will assist us through our entire lives. Our first year of high school was very atypical, as it was cut short due to COVID-19 and the ongoing pandemic. These unprecedented times were very alarming to everyone, but especially us, as we were only 14 or 15 years old and just beginning high school. However, even through a global pandemic, lockdowns, virtual schools, and so many mandates, all of us sitting here today got through it while showing resiliency and perseverance. Life will always be an uphill battle, and sometimes we're going to have to lose. So being exposed to hardships like this will only make us stronger in the end. Mineola class of 2023, it has been a pleasure to stand up here today in honor of us and to commend all of our hard work. I hope that some of what I said tonight resonates with you throughout life, wherever it may take you. I believe that we all have the capability to flourish in our own ways, and above all, to enjoy what we do. Take pleasure and satisfaction in what you achieve. Whatever your next steps may be, I invite you to see your studies here as part of a lifetime of learning and the stepping stones to becoming a better you. Thank you, and God bless.
And now, our third, fourth, and fifth-ranked seniors, Molly Fisher, John Laredo, and Madeline Tucker, will give the history of the class.
First and foremost, congratulations to all the seniors who've made it here today. The journey has been arduous and has taken our entire lifetimes up to this point. Today, the journey comes to an end, and we welcome a new and exciting part of our lives. As we leave high school and walk out into the real world, let us reminisce on the moments which have made the past 12 years more fun and memorable. We started our educational journey in kindergarten with Chris Alejo, Aubrey Bedford, Ryan Bethel, Adam Blaylock, Cameron Bussell, Jacob Castleberry, Randall Cash, Alex Castillo, Brittany Christopherson, James Clower, Bobby Collins, Noah Collins, Yamilet Cortez, Owen Coutre, Ashton Crowley, Kason Davis, Hannah Davlin, Gracie Finley, Lauren Dickerson, Miley Fisher, Parker Gant, Chloe Garcia, Isaiah Gardner, Jesse Gilbreth, Zoe Goodson, Michaela Gould, Lindsay Harris, Haley Haston, Carmen Heim, Chevy Hogue, Ariel Jackson, Johnny Jones, Spencer Joyner, Cameron Karsh, Shyla Kretzmeyer, Eduardo Lopez, Savannah Lopez, John Lucas Laredo, Jairo Mata, Lexi Miller, Corbin Mize, Ben Navarro, Preston Radla, Juan Rocha, Maddie Sheeran, Joel Smith, Benjamin Spofford, Emily Tremble, Madeline Tucker, Cindy Van Cleve, Vanessa Velaz, and Jocelyn Whitehead. Kindergarten was the year of all our first. We were introduced to competition through AR books and the dreadful pacer test. Our teachers taught us to go anywhere in the school, you had to have a bubble in your mouth and hands behind your back. We also had many fights this year, but just over who got to be the line leader or help the teachers pass out papers. You can't forget us eating green eggs and ham, which left an interesting smell in the halls, but our hot chocolate was much better when we watched the Polar Express. The next year we moved on to first grade and were joined by Tanner Crenshaw. This was the year when we sang American Tears at the Veterans Day Assembly, which made everyone cry. We also learned about Native Americans by dressing up and having strange names like Crazy Lion or Joyful Horse. In second grade, Conlon Benavides, Noah Holland, Jet Vaughn, and Alex Worsham joined us. This was the first time we were the big fish on campus. We all felt like cool kids being the oldest, even though we still needed help tying our shoes. We put on a show-stopping Christmas play with Joel Smith and Bailey Sales as our Mr. and Mrs. Claus. We also got to channel our countryside when we rode our trusty stick ponies through the halls. As we moved on to our first year of elementary school, we picked up Joseph Gandy and Riley Woodward. We did have a little bit of a hard time adjusting to this campus, but since they always claimed we were too loud in the cafeteria, which resulted in us having to sit on the blacktop all of recess. And the teachers always wondered why we were still so rowdy when we returned to class. This year, we learned our first instrument, the recorder. Starting off with hot cross buns, everyone was trying to receive their black belt.
Fourth grade brought us Dalton Anders, Dakota Brown, and Kira Dunn. This was the year of the Riding Star test, and we had to do Camp Ride Along, where we rode all day for a whole week. In fifth grade, we got to add new members to our class once again. This year, it was Hunter Collier, Jackson Daigle, Aiden Dudley, Jenna Haggerton, and Jonathan Gallego-Solerio. It was now our turn to go on the infamous Sky Ranch trip, except it turned out to be a little bit more painful than expected when Cindy Van Cleve fell off the bench and had to go to the hospital. However, we still made the best of the trip by creating skits and pranking each other. This was when we finally moved on to middle school, and in sixth grade, we were joined by Allie Hooten, Caitlin McLemore, Killian Russell, and Tin Tran. Middle school was the year of new beginnings, where we started to find our friend groups and what extracurriculars to pursue. We got introduced to the Jacket Bookstore, which had some awesome incentive prizes. This was also the year that everyone's favorite event occurred, the wedding and fight. Alex Castillo and Jordan Calloway got married on the playground on March 20th, and Alex stole his grandmother's ring to give it to his new wife. They had to spend their honeymoon in ISS for the next few days. That same day, two of the eighth graders started fighting, and it ended with Mr. Sorensen getting punched in the face, supposedly. In seventh grade, we picked up Allie Gonzalez, Brandon Hembright, Alyssa Levin, and Sean Piercy. This year had an event that is almost more memorable than the year before. In seventh grade, we went to the Freshwater Fishery Center in Athens and were able to go fishing. However, Lauren Dickerson accidentally hit Mira in the head with her fishing rod, causing a fish hook to go through her hat, and she had to go to the ER. When we returned to school, Mrs. Witt told them that they got the biggest catch and gave them both jacket books. We had another scare when Jocelyn Whitehead swallowed a magnet from Maddie Sheeran's locker. Our additions in eighth grade were Mia Backer, Dawson Pendergrass, Walter Lyman, and Brady Shrum. During this year, the group of athletic boys often found themselves in trouble, whether it was from wearing too short of shorts, making Coach Tittle carry around a dollar bill with him at all times to protect the length, or stealing and eating donuts. They never failed to cause a ruckus. The eighth grade dance was one for the books, We killed all the lion dances like the Cupid Shuffle and Cotton Eye Joe. But looking back, let's be glad we don't dress like that anymore. It was a sad day when we experienced our last Turkey Mania and Water Day. We finally made it to the last stretch entering high school with Maddie Minyard joining us for freshman year. In the fall of 2019, the band earned their second consecutive first place medal at the state marching contest. After spring break this year, we were informed that we would get to extend our time off because of this infectious disease called COVID-19. During this extended amount of time, online classes became a substitute for our face-to-face instruction. Everyone soon determined that success in this type of education really amounted to how well you could Google. Because of the absence of our usual instruction, we even got out of taking the biology star test.
Our sophomore year began with the additions of Destiny Angelina, Allie Jordan, Campbell Littlefield, Gracie Parrish, and JP. This year, we were still recovering from the pandemic, but we were lucky to resume in-person education. However, we were still required to wear a mask at school at all times. At the same time, the classes began getting their driver's license, and I believe we were all scared for our lives at some point. Our grade had a very successful sophomore year when TJ Moreland and Brady Schrum were on the state-winning 4x4 team. Junior year rolled around, and we were joined by Charisma Castorina, Madison Radcliffe, and Nicholas Quinn. As we finally became upperclassmen, the classes we took got a lot more difficult. For example, the class learned the true benefit of Quizlet as we struggled through TJC U.S. history. At the homecoming bonfire, we were all shocked when Campbell Littlefield was thrown too far back in the basket toss and fell on the ground, which caused her to break her back and nose. However, rumor was going around that the cheerleaders threw her directly into the fire. But since I was in that stunt group, I can say that is false. Another event this fall that was quite memorable was when there was a bomb threat on the same day as our Veteran Day's assembly, and we all had to evacuate to the field. In our senior year, we welcomed Caleb Hardinson and Jana Weddle. We were also lucky to have two bonus students who planned to graduate early, Valerie Moreland and Brooke Latterman. We cannot forget to mention Mr. Sorensen joining us in his final years of education as well. This year, we have experienced many lasts. Our last time stepping on the field, court, track, or stage. Our last homecoming, prom, and so much more. We crowned Allie Gonzalez and Isaiah Gardner as homecoming royalty. And at prom, Jairo Mata and Campbell Littlefield as prom king and queen. The boys basketball team also made school history when they made it to the regional finals. We wrapped up our education career with senior week, where we got to soak up the final days all together. I think we can all agree that the class of 2023 has been through a lot together, from learning how to read to becoming mature adults, well, some of us. And that brings us to where we are now. Now, we are all about to begin the next chapter of our lives, ready or not. Goodbyes are never easy, but goodbye MISD, and thank you for all the memories.
At this time, I would like to welcome the valedictorian of the class of 2023, Miss Allie Jordan.
Good evening, everyone. Can you all hear me okay? All right, awesome. I'd like to begin by recognizing a few important people that are here tonight. First off, I'd like to thank the administration and school board members present. I know we are all very grateful for your ongoing support and dedication to Mineola ISD. I'd also like to recognize all of the educators present, whether you're a current teacher at Mineola or elsewhere, a retired teacher, or even a sub. You all have had an undeniable impact on your students, and your contributions to our lives have and will continue to shape and guide us for the years ahead. My mom and my aunt are here, with the latter coming all the way from Indiana on a train ride, I might add. And I'm very, very grateful for their attendance tonight and their support over the years. Thank you so much for sticking with me through the ups and downs, and for being here for me at times when no one else was. We don't have much family around here, aside from my mom, who I live with, So thank you so much for making the trip for me. And finally, I want to recognize my dad, Daniel Jordan. Sorry. I'm sorry, he passed away when I was very young, so I'd like to believe that he is here in spirit. Sorry. Okay. We as graduating students have been exploring and evaluating our senses of self over the past 18 years, give or take, and although we have all traveled different paths, I believe there are a few common ideas that we should all consider and adopt for the years ahead. There have been many experiences, both good and bad, that have shaped who we are as individuals and how we react to and work with others. And while I wholeheartedly believe that every experience and subsequent reaction or consequence is completely valid, I wish to stress that despite these instances of hardship, it is still very important to focus on the road ahead and maintain a healthy outlook. In order to support one another along this journey we are about to embark on, it is important to remember that a healthy lifestyle is subjective. Therefore, it will manifest differently depending on the person. For one person, a healthy life may involve taking more risks, while another person's definition of a healthy mindset may mean being a little more careful. Failing to take these points into consideration will lead to difficulty for those involved and make it impossible to truly support and accept others. Another subjective idea that I'd like to bring attention to is success, or what one may deem success. I know many of us have big dreams and even loftier goals. And while I believe it is necessary to attempt to achieve them with hard work and dedication, it is also necessary to acknowledge that everyone's idea of success is different and ever-changing, and that is okay. Goals are allowed to change. Plans are allowed to change. It is often difficult to predict outcomes for educational or career paths, or even just life in general, and failure will undoubtedly present itself. But if anything, failure and change spur us into reaching new heights, and allow us to truly prosper, whether by completing a goal or establishing a new one. So, as we move forward and begin to pursue our many aspirations, let us embrace change and allow it to become a catalyst for success, whatever that may look like for you. Perhaps the most important quality to maintain is acceptance. Like I said before, healthy lifestyles and definitions of success vary from person to person, and the same goes for many other aspects of life, including beliefs, desires, and choices. Although we may not always agree with one another, showing respect is often the greatest thing people can offer each other. Without showing others this basic decency, we cannot truthfully expect to be treated with the same consideration. Mutual respect, more than all else, is what will allow us to succeed both as individuals and as leaders of a functional up-and-coming society. With that, I congratulate every one of the graduating seniors present, and I genuinely wish you all a successful and fulfilling life. I hope that we are all able to continue to overcome challenges and struggles with grace and understanding, and that we may show that same grace and understanding to others when they are in need. I have genuinely enjoyed my time at Mineola High School and all of the opportunities that I have been so blessed to be able to participate in. Once again, thank you all so much for the support and positivity that have allowed me and each of my peers to flourish. And to my class, let us now go forward and make wonderful lives for ourselves, whether they include larger-than-life accomplishments or simply consist of quiet fulfillment and sincerity. Go now and enjoy your lives, for they are worth living.
And now we'd like to recognize our top 10 honor graduates. Their hard work and determination have placed them at the top of their graduating class, and we're very proud of their accomplishments. As I call your name, please step forward and turn and face the audience. Number 10, Mr. Riley Woodward. Number 9, Audrey Bedford. Number 8, Zoe Goodson. Number 7, Vanessa Velaz. Number 6, Jonathan Gallegos. Number 5, Madeline Tucker. Number 4, John Laredo. Number 3, Miley Fisher. Number 2, Campbell Littlefield. And number 1, Allie Jordan. Let's give them a hand. Thank you, top 10. You may be seated. Mr. Mize and the Mineola Board of Trustees, I certify that these graduates have fulfilled all requirements under the state of Texas and the Mineola Independent School District and are prepared to receive their diplomas. At this time, our superintendent of schools, Mr. Cody Mize, will certify the graduates of the class of 2023.
Graduates, before we certify you tonight, I wanted to make sure that we thank the very special person that's here with us this evening. I have joked with Mr. Sorensen all throughout the year that if you study numerology, 40 years is a period of testing. And anything past 40 years is absolute glutton for punishment. And Mr. Sorensen has served public education. He is finishing tonight 41 years of service to children. And Mr. Sorensen, because you chose to serve our district, our state, our country, our world, it's a better place. And we thank you for that service. Graduates, by the authority vested in me by the state of Texas, and on behalf of the Mineola ISD Board of Trustees, and with your principal, Mr. Mike Sorensen, I hereby certify that you have met all of the requirements of a high school graduate in the state of Texas. It is my great pleasure to inform you that you are now ready to receive your diplomas. Congratulations.
And now, we will call the graduates to come receive their diplomas.
Ladies and gentlemen, presenting the diplomas of the graduating class of 2023, beginning with the top 10 students, Allie Marie Jordan, Carrie Emily Campbell Littlefield, Miley Grace Fisher, John Lucas Laredo, Madeline Claire Tucker, Jonathan Gallego Silerio, Vanessa Velaz, my favorite senior of the class of 23, we love you, Zoe Mae Goodson, Aubrey Danielle Bedford, Riley Cole Woodward, Chris Ulysses Alejo, Dalton Evan Anders. Ramsey Catherine Allen Anderson. Mia Catherine Baker. Kaylee Renee Ballou. Caden Chance Bell. Conlon Isaiah Benavides. Brian David Bethel. Olivia Faith Black. Adam Lynn Blaylock. Dakota Lee Brown. Cameron Ty Butzel. Randall Lane Cash. Charisma Alessandra Castaneda. Alexander Jace Castillo. Jacob Jeremiah Castleberry. Lorenzo Castorena. Brittany Rain Christofferson. Robert James Clower. Hunter Cole Collier. Bobby Wayne Collins. Noah Wiley Collins. Madison Grace Cook. Yamilet Zuniga Cortez. Owen Corduroy Coutre. Michael Tanner Crenshaw. Ashton Daytona Crowley. Alejandra Noemi Cruz. Jackson James Daigle. Kason Lynn Davis. Hannah Hope Davlin. James Robert DeGarmo Jr. Lauren Renee Dickerson. Aiden Patrick Dudley. Kira Alice Dunn. Yadira Dana Espina. Justin Lane Evans. Gracie Ann Finley. Joseph Leon Gandy Jr. Parker Stewart Lee Gant. Chloe Nicole Garcia. Isaiah Lamar Gardner. Jesse James Gilbreth. Ileana Elizabeth Gomez Hernandez. Aaliyah Marie Gonzalez. Natalie Gonzalez. Michaela Lynn Gould. Anthony Carter Griffith II. Gianni Castillo Gutierrez. Jenna Catherine Haggerton. Brandon Lee Hambright. Caleb James Hardison. Lindsay Nicole Harris. Tanner Leanne Hartzog. Haley D. Haston. Landon Kirk Hazelwood. Carmen Lynn Heim. Amy Guadalupe Hernandez. Chevy Ray Hogue. Noah Dean Holland. Allison Kate Hooten. Madeline Rose Marie Irby Sheeran. Ariel Dominique Jackson. Avery Taryn Elizabeth Jenkins. Johnny Earl Jones Jr. Spencer Ty Joyner. Cameron Albert Karch. Jamarcus Rashad Kennedy. Candon Isaac King. Shyla Ray Kretzmeyer. Eduardo Lopez. Savannah Seat Clali Lopez. Marcus. Danielle Louderman. Alyssa Sue Lovin. Walter William Lyman Jr. Prince J.P. Alom Magsayo. Jairo Alexander Mata. Destiny Angelina McElyea. Caitlin Mackenzie McLemore. Alexis Grace Miller. Maddie Mae Minyard. Corbin Riley Mize. Dylan Isaiah Alexander Moose. Timothy James Moreland. Valerie Ann Moreland. Benjamin Lane Navarro. Jaden Sergio Neverez. Darvin Edward Newsom Jr. Jose Alejandro Rodriguez Palacios. Gracie Mae Parrish. Josephine Rosalie Parrish. William Dawson Pendergrass. Sean Ryan Piercy. Sebastian Allen Poole. Nicholas Cole Quinn. Madison Rianne Radcliffe. Preston Jace Radla. Juan Pablo Rocha. Natalie Ann Rogers. Alicia Rodriguez. Killian Murphy Russell. Brady Grant Shrum. Joel Ryan Smith. Benjamin Adams Spotsford. Mira Leigh Jackson Stamper. Sherilyn Torres Torres. Tin Trung Tran. Emily Ann Tremble. Sydney Grace Van Cleve. Jet Paul Vaughn. Amanda Vega. Marissa Jean Ventura. Jana Elizabeth Weddle. Alejandro Lucas White. Jocelyn Grace Whitehead. Kiana Nicole Marie Williams. Alexander Earl Worsham.
Graduating class of 2023, would you please rise? With the turning of your tassels, it is my honor to declare you graduates of Mineola High School. I know you.
We would like to take this opportunity to thank you for coming tonight. As we complete our graduation exercises, we will now ask you to bow as we say a word of prayer for our seniors, and then we will close with the school song. Our gracious Heavenly Father, another school year has come to an end, and we have only you to thank for this celebration of success. Without you, we would have not made it to this amazing day where we will start the rest of our lives apart from high school. We thank you for the teachers who have supported us throughout our curriculum and have guided us each year in order to reach success. Thank you for all the friends we have made along the way and for all the memories we couldn't have had without your hand. We thank you so much for our time together as we graduate and step into this next journey of our lives. Jeremiah 29:11. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future. As in these words, help us to remain with the plan you have for us and guide us to live each day in your name so that we may prosper. Please remain with us as we find strength in you for our upcoming life journey and give us direction as we enter the world. As this chapter on our life closes, so a new one begins. We humbly ask you to empower us as we start our new adventures. We ask you that you lead the way as we continue to be guided by your will. We pray that with your guidance, we will remain on your marked path, celebrating you in our lives every day. Please continue to bless our lives with your goodness and enable us to stay true to our dreams for your glory. We ask this in your glorious name. Amen.